In today's guide, you will learn how to use Microsoft Teams mobile app on iPhone. So follow me, let me put you through on everything you need to know and how to complete some tasks on it.
Using Microsoft Teams starts with the installation of the application on your iPhone. All right, so here, get to App Store and then get it installed. As the App Store opens, tap on the search area and then type the application we want to install. Here we want to install Microsoft Teams, all right? As the application shows up in the search result, tap on install and open it. Here I have installed the application already on my iPhone as a mobile app. So I will tap on open for it to open. Once the application opens, if you are using it for the first time, you will have a clean interface. Here I have used it for meeting before, and that's why you have meeting with Matt Anderson and another contact named Kevin Rail. But if you are using it for the first time, this interface will be clean. All right. Once the Teams app opens, you are landed on the chat tab. That is why it is selected at the bottom part of the screen. Okay, the one that has messaging icon. The other tabs you have there are the home, calendar, and notification. If you tap on the home, it allows you to create some groups or search for groups you already created by tapping in the search area. Okay. So you can see the first option here says create my group. Maybe you have some team members and members of your organization you want to have in a particular group to discuss something crucial about the organization. You then tap on create my group and give it a name. All right. Then there are some suggested group names to you. You have school, you have business, you have sports, you have professional, you have events, you have arts and culture, gaming, youth organization, neighborhood, parent, volunteering. Okay, so if any of these suggestions fits into what you want to do, just tap on the name, then edit it or just follow on to create it. All right, for example, if you want to use this professional, you tap on it and the professional is already assigned here as a name, just tap on create. Or if you want to add some numbers or some other letters to it, you add it and create. But here I don't want to create any group, so let's get back to chat again. Then another tab at the bottom part is calendar. So when you tap on that, it opens the calendar page. All right. So here you can schedule events or community events or meeting now. Maybe you want to have a meeting, a video live video meeting with people right now. So you can get to that through here. All right. Then you have notification, which is next. This displays the notifications you get from members of your team. Maybe someone, a contact, chatted you. You get a notification that somebody chatted you, or maybe the conversation you were having, somebody added a like emoji, so it appears in notification that somebody has done such thing, so you can check out. All right, so let's get back to chat. Now at the top part you can see the profile. SA is the profile of this account. All right, so when you tap on that profile, it shows you some other menu items. Let's try it out, okay? Okay, you can see the first one is my name with my email address attached to it, though I blocked it for security purposes. You can see the status of my account, am I available? You have set status message, all right? So maybe you want to add status message, tap there, and then you can say, active, all right? Or anything, just say anything of your choice, okay? Then after that, tap on done. So let's get back to the menu again. Then you have notifications, you have it's turned on, you have settings, you have your current benefits, okay? Saved files, add accounts. So there are lots you can do through the menu item, all right? So once you tap on your profile, you have some options. Then let's start a chat. For you to start a chat with someone, make sure you're on the chat tab, all right? Once you're on the chat tab, then tap on start new chat icon. That is that pen-like icon at the bottom right. Once you do that, the contacts on your phone will be displayed to you because you're using mobile in this case. But some of your contacts may not be on Microsoft Teams. They may not have accounts with Microsoft Teams. So no need of you selecting them. But if you know any contact that has Microsoft Teams accounts, you can just scroll down, tap on the name and start discussion with him. All right. But in this case, I want to type the email address of the person I want to communicate with. Okay. So another way you can get to someone you want to chat with is by typing the email address. So type the email address and it will pop up and we start chat with him or her. Another way is typing the name of the person. If he's a member of your organization, maybe you have an organizational account, he's a member, an employee in the company, just type in the name. It will pop up because it's part of the organization. You tap on the name and then you start the conversation with him or her. But in this case, I'm going to tap the email address of the contact and we start the chat. KevinMike942@gmail.com. So he has an account with Microsoft, all right? So he has Teams account. So his name has pop up. I will tap on it and then I will tap on next. You can see the chat conversation has opened. So I can say, bro, what's up with you? So once you finish typing the message you want to send to him to start the conversation, tap on send. So Kevin has received this message from his end. So he's going to respond to me. He's online. So let's wait for him to see if he will respond. You can see he's typing. All right. And Kevin responded to me, good bro. So I can continue the conversation with him from here. All right. So if I want to call him on video, all I need to do is just to tap on the video icon at the top right. If I want to call him on voice call, I will tap on the voice call icon and we start talking on voice. All right. So if I want to send emoji or react to what he sends as a message, I will log press on that. Then I will select an emoji there. All right. So that's how to add emoji in chat when you're using Microsoft Teams. So let's get back to the chat app and see other things we can do. On this chat app, you can see another thing you can do. You can see meet at the top. Okay. So when you tap on that meet, it allows you to schedule meeting or start meeting with members of your organization or with someone. So let's experiment. So I will tap on meet and then you can see the options given to me, meet now or join with meeting ID. Maybe there's a meeting that is going on and you want to join with the meeting ID. You select that option. But here I want to start a meeting. So I will tap on the option meet now. Now this opens a page like this. It says meeting with Matt Anderson. That's my name in this case. And it says share meeting invite. Okay, if I want to share meeting invite, I will select that option and then copy meeting meeting link and more options. So you want to have see more options, you tap on the more options given there. All right. So but here I want to start meeting. So I will tap on start meeting.
Once this interface opens, you'll have the options invite people to join, add participant and share meeting invites. Here we want to add participants, so tap on that option. On the next page, which you can see right now, type the email address or the name of the member of your organization and select him. Kevin has accepted the call, the video call from his end. I can enable the audio and also enable the video so that we can see each other as we talk. Once you're done with the meeting, end the call.
So once you leave, the people you added, the participants will get the information that you have left. So they will then leave from their own end. So that is how to use Meet in Microsoft Teams mobile application. Okay, I'm still on the chat tab, all right? So let me just walk you through a few other things you can do for us to conclude this tutorial. You can see at the top right, there is a filter icon there. So when you tap on that, you see some eye options. You can see on red, you can see meeting, you can see muted, all right? So take for example, you want to see some meeting calls you had on this app. You select the meeting. So that will be the only message that will display on the chat area. If you want to see your unread messages, you select the unread option. If you want to filter down to muted, you select muted. Okay, so that's what the filter does and how to use it in Microsoft Teams. Then let's get back to the menu item whereby I tap on my profile to see some other things. I want us to access settings. All right, so when you tap on your profile, you will see your email address and your name as well. But our interest here is to access settings. So I want to teach you how you can do a few things through the settings option, all right? The settings menu item. So select settings. On selecting settings, this page will be displayed. First, you have a section called general. And under general, you have appearance and data and storage, okay? Then when you tap on appearance, it allows you to change theme. By default, the system default is selected. But if you want to activate dark theme, you select dark. You can see the theme has turned to dark. If you want to select light, you select light. It has turned to light. But if you want to go with the system default, select it so that the system will choose the best theme for you at a particular point in time. All right, so let's go back. Then you have data and storage. When you tap on that, it shows you some information concerning data and storage. Here it says Microsoft Cloud Storage. I have 2 gig of 5 gig used. All right, so you can see other things like Teams local storage, clear download file, downloaded files, clear app data, and some other things. You can see video calls. You see reduce data usage, never. So let it flow as it's supposed to flow. But if you want to reduce data usage, you could just tap on that and then select on cellular networks or always. All right, so we go back. Then we have message media. We have image upload quality. Automatic is selected by default, but if you want something different, you go there and select always send full size, or always send in high resolution, or always send low resolution. So it's left for you to make the choice. So let's get back to the settings page again, the main settings page. You can see profile. You can change some things about your profile notification. You can change some things about notifications. You can see message. You can see people. You can see calling. Okay, you can see caption. You can see team insider program. All these are settings. So when you tap on each of them, you see some things you can change. School connection has to do with school connection settings. About, if you want to know more about this particular app, you go with the about option. So when you tap on about, you will see some things about this. You can see Microsoft Teams version 6.14.1. All right, and so many other details about its copyright at 2024. So there are a lot of information you are going to see about the current application you're using, the Teams app. So let's get back. All right, you can sign out from this settings space. Take for example, you want to sign out for another person to sign into the app, just tap on sign out and follow the on-screen guide. If you want to delete your Teams account, you do that through the settings page. All you need to do is to tap on delete account and follow the on-screen guide. Okay, so let's get back to the chat. And with this, I believe you can find your way around Microsoft Teams mobile application on iPhone. Even if you use an Android, it still shares similar interface. Thank you.
I believe you find this guide helpful. Please, if it does help, consider subscribing to my channel. Here we discuss technology. So if you want to learn tech, please subscribe. Okay, hit the like button, the one that points up. All right, not the one that points down, the one that points up, so that YouTube will recommend this content to more people. If we don't do that, there's no how the system will know that this content is helpful. Okay, leave a comment in the comment section. Let me know how you feel about this. Does this solve the problem that brought you here, or is there any other question you want to ask? Just leave that in the comment section. Watch this video to learn more on how to complete some tasks in Microsoft Teams using your laptop. Thank you, and see you some other time.